do.
Did you want to do?
Josh? Good, yeah.
106 points. Yeah, that was great. All right. Again, Rhonda told me, I didn't get told, but as I left last night.
1573.
16?
15.
1573. All right. Have y'all got things planned for summer already or no?
Not yet, but we're going to.
Okay. Good deal. That'll help. That'll go a long way.
Absolutely.
In fact, we need to do that again this fall. All right. We had a good time this morning. I did preaching on the donkeyology. And actually, I'm going to continue with that same message tonight, just kind of in a different route. But anyway, don't forget now, this Saturday is the Easter egg hunt. That'll be from 2 to 4.
Yep.
And it'll be here at the church. So if you got some kids, round up the neighborhood and kids or whatever, and bring them over here to the Easter egg hunt. And then Sunday morning, of course, Easter morning, we'll have the sunrise breakfast. And we'll be here early to cook and we'll eat at 6 and have a service at 7. And then we'll come back. No Sunday school Sunday morning, next Sunday. But we'll have 11 o'clock Easter service. So I'm looking forward to that. Be praying for this revival. I've talked to a couple of the speakers this last week or so, and they're excited to be coming. And Erica Joe is coming to help lead the singing, and I believe we'll have a good time. All right. Robert. They had to move Robert this afternoon. His cough got worse. And so they took him back to ER at Lourdes. And so they'll probably put him, I don't think they'll put him in a unit, but they'll probably put him in a room at Lourdes until he gets better. So let's remember Robert. Chad called me this afternoon about 2 or 3 o'clock. They were in the process. Well, he was already there. When he went down to see him this morning, he recognized right away that he really needed to go to the doctor. And so just pray for Robert. Robert is really struggling. Robert can't get out of the chair by himself. He can't get up. He has no strength in his legs and his arms. And so remember him. Anyone else?
Y'all look like y'all are.
Your best friend died or something.
Maybe you remember our oldest son, Jacob. He is traveling back from Japan tomorrow.
Okay. All right. On that note, let's remember Sid. I think they're either coming back this weekend or next this week. I'm not sure. The last chance or the last conversation I had with him. In fact, he messaged today, and I'm not sure if he was in France or Spain or where he was at. Him and Vicky are overseas somewhere, and he did message today though. Wanted to know how much the Barlow sold for after the night. But anyway, I told him it was still up for sale.
You got enough money.
Anyway, but pray for Sid and Vicky as they travel over there. All right. Anything else?
We would love to thank everybody that turned up yesterday for the fundraiser and everybody that donated items. You guys are an absolute blessing.
Amen. Amen. That was such a blessing to be a part of that. I thank everybody this morning, Troy, for being a part of that and all the hard work that went into that. It took a lot of preparation to do that. I know y'all really worked at that. So we thank God for the people. All right. Anything else?
Brother,
yes.
Brian and Heather are going to be traveling this evening. They're going up to Minnesota from Taylor. Mm-hmm. He's supposed to be really bad weather. And I called him and told him he's still going. So just.
Okay. Let's pray for Brian and Heather as they travel up there. That's a long trip. All right. I mentioned this morning, Brother David will be preaching next Sunday up at LBL. Lift him up in prayer this week that souls will be saved up there. I did get word this afternoon. I stay in contact with several churches. And Alan and I, Alan Morris, and we've been friends for several years. And Alan is pastoring New Hope Baptist Church. And they had an evangelist in this weekend preaching today at New Hope, and Brother Brent Carr. I've heard Brent on YouTube. He's an excellent preacher. But anyway, God moved over there today, and I think there was five saved over there today. All right, anything else? All right, let's pray. Lord, we just love you tonight. All of our being, God, we just love you with all we are. Father, there's no one could have done in our lives what you've done. Lord, I thank you for our church, God, how loving they are, how giving they are. Lord, they just love you. They love to be a part of what you're doing. Lord, I thank you for our youth. God, I pray that what was raised last night, God, will bless them this year. God, as they use it, God, they bring glory and honor to your name. Father, we just thank you for the opportunity to give to them. Lord, tonight, we just ask you to meet with us here. Lord, pour out your spirit. Let us worship you in spirit and truth tonight. As your word comes forth, God, I pray, God, that you would use it for your glory. Change hearts and lives forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good evening, church.
Good evening.
Good to see all of you this evening. Glad to have our mics back on. Thank you, Troy, for figuring that out. And hopefully we'll get the rest of it back up and going here. Maybe we can get two or three guys learn how to do that. Maybe that way if somebody's not here, we can...
Yeah, I've been mentioning that. If somebody would like to volunteer and go over and learn how to do that, so we've got two or three different people.
Well, I know Jeannie said something about she was going to learn how to do it, but maybe Dennis said he was going to learn how to do it, so there's two more. Sound like Floyd might be interested in doing it. All right, good to see all of you. Hope y'all enjoyed this beautiful day the Lord blessed us with today. Man, it's just wonderful to be out. That's my kind of weather up there right now. And we're just going to come praising the Lord. He's worthy of our praise. We're going to praise him in song. And we're going to start out tonight with page 75, I'll Fly Away. Some let morning when his life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. When I die.
We got CD.
Yeah.
Do what?
We've got it all.
Got the CD working?
Yeah.
We're gonna try it anyway.
Okay. If we can get it going, it'll be a old church choir.
All right, here we go.
And spreading like a wildfire in my heart. Sunday morning, hallelujah, and it's lasting all week long. Can you hear it? Can you feel it? It's the rhythm of a gospel song.
Love Friend. So it's page 259 if you do have a book.
Including in these totals is the food given on every Friday to local agencies Not One Miss has been able to supply others in Kentucky, Enon Baptist Church, St. Paul, Fulton First Methodist, Assembly of God, Eastern Kentucky Flood Victim, the Mission House in Clinton, R6 Men's House. Also, we've been able to supply a New Beginning for Women, Wingo Elementary Head Start, Helping Hands of Benton, Paducah Kitchen, and different blessing boxes located throughout the area. We humbly thank you for your financial support and are asking you for prayers for our food ministry and wonderful volunteers. We are informing you the Mayfield distribution point, the old Sparks Elementary, has been closed due to the property being sold by the owner. We will only serve food at 98 Calvary Church Road in Mayfield. Joey Green, president. So I just thought I'd read that to you. That's a blessing, folks. That the ministry that Joey and Eddie have got before them, they feed thousands and thousands of people. That's just amazing for a little community like ours. And I know some of y'all are a part of that on a regular basis. And I thank God for you as you do that. All right, if you have your Bibles tonight, turn with me to John chapter 12. As I stated this morning, the triumphal entry into Jerusalem is in all four Gospels, and I'm going to read a different passage tonight. This one's out of John on the entry into Jerusalem. It's a little bit shorter than Mark chapter 11, and then I'll go right into the sermon. Verse 12, John 12, 12. John 12, 12. All right, on the next day, much people that were come to the feast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, took branches of palm trees and went forth to meet him and cried, Hosanna, blessed is the King of Israel that cometh in the name of the Lord. And Jesus, when he had found a young ass, sat thereon, as it is written, Fear not, daughter of Zion, behold, thy King cometh, sitting on an ass's coat. That's Zechariah 9:9. I mentioned that this morning. These things understood not his disciples at the first. But when Jesus was glorified, then remembered they that these things were written of him, and that they had done these things unto him. The people therefore that was with him, when he called Lazarus out of the grave and raised him from the dead, bear record. For this cause the people also met him, for they had heard that he had done this miracle. The Pharisees therefore said among themselves, Perceive ye how ye prevail nothing. Behold, the world is gone after him. Lord, we thank you for your word tonight. Lord, help us to understand more of it every day as we study and we read it. God, let us hide it in our hearts. Lord, I believe that there's coming a day when it's going to be a must for us to have your word hid in our heart. Yes. We're going to have to give an explanation of why we believe what we do when the world comes against us. And Lord, I pray that we'll be ready at that day. Yes. God, as we stand fast in your word, stand fast in prayer, God, lifting your name up. And you tell us in your word, Lord, that if we'll lift your name up, you'll draw all men to you. Father, thank you for doing that. Thank you for all the souls we've seen saved, God. Continue to work, Lord. Only you can do that. We thank you and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I was thinking about the donkey. As I mentioned that donkey this morning, and by the way, I hope y'all got a good donkey nap today. But as I was thinking about that donkey and the things that that donkey does. Did you know that a lot of cattle farmers buy donkeys to put in their fields?
Yeah.
Do you know why they do that? A donkey, its natural instinct is to ward off any enemy of sheep or cattle. In other words, that donkey, if a coyote or a wolf comes into that pasture, that donkey will absolutely run it off or kill it before it can get near the sheep. Isn't that good to know? And no wonder Jesus chose the donkey to ride in on in that respect. And And so then I got to thinking about why did they choose the palm trees? Somebody said this morning to me after as I was leaving, there was no palm trees in that area. If they were only in the desert areas. I don't know how true that is. Dennis, you might be able to tell us. But then I got to thinking about the palm tree itself and thought about maybe God inspired them to use that because the palm tree is one of the most unique trees in the world. And what I mean by that is the palm tree has one of the deepest root systems of any tree in the world. That's why you will see when a hurricane comes on the shores of the ocean, you'll see those palm trees. They have the unique ability to completely bend in a hurricane gale and not be broken, but after the storm's over, they rise back up. And folks, when I think about that, I think about no wonder God used palm leaves to walk on and going into his triumphal entry. The strongest tree that was ever created, he created that same tree, those palm branches, for his glory. And you and I, when we start, we just stop and think about these things every once in a while, we would see how magnificent our God is. I remember we watched a film one time. Lou Giglio narrated the film, and it's called How Great Is Our God.
Yeah.
Man, what a! I wish I had that video. I don't have it anymore. But it signifies how great our God is, and it depicts the universe that we live in. It's amazing how God could have created the universe the way he did and put everything into motion. Synchronized the earth and the sun, the earth rotating in the way that it does, and it doesn't not listen. It's just amazing how God put all that together so that you and I could watch that and see the glory of God being revealed. That just amazes me, it fascinates me. But tonight, did you notice what the scripture said? It said those people. The people, therefore, that was with him when he called Lazarus out of the grave. Jesus is riding in on the donkey, and people are shouting, Hosanna in the highest. Praise the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is here. And they're shouting and praising. And at one point, even in one of the Gospels, the Pharisees, by the way, it said, Master, rebuke your disciples because they're causing a stir. They're making too much noise. And you know what Jesus said? He said, if I rebuke them, the stones will cry out. Oh, I like that. The stones sometimes got more, the rocks got more sense than we got. And so Jesus is making his way down the streets of Jerusalem, down from Bethpage and Bethany, coming down through the Kidron Valley, and then coming back up the hill into Jerusalem at the East Gate. And through the throngs of people, he's making his way on that little floppy-eared donkey that's carrying him and lifting him up so the people can see him. And I'm looking, and so I want you tonight, I want you to look with me for just a few minutes. I won't keep you long, but I want you to look with me as he travels down that road. And he looks out among the crowds at what he sees. Can you imagine with me tonight what he must have thought? It said he beheld Jerusalem in the background and he began to weep because of Jerusalem's failure to recognize who he was. The chosen people that God had led all of their lives for 49 generations were still rejecting the Messiah. And he wept over Jerusalem because his heart was aching for them to come and accept him as their Lord and Savior, but they would not. Don't you know that God's heart aches when we, as young people, a lot of times we're running wild and free and we're not thinking about God or anything about God in our lives. But for every once in a while, don't you think God looks down and sees those lost people and weeps over them and wishes and prays that we would come to know Christ as our Savior? I believe he does. So as Christ is looking at the crowd, first of all, his disciples were with him, because we know that two of them were with him because he sent two of them to get the donkey. So the disciples are walking along, and I gotta just hang with me. I'm gonna try to paint you a picture here. Peter is walking along beside the donkey, probably holding one of them floppy ears. He's got one ear, he's probably on this side, he's got one ear on the donkey's ear, or one hand on the donkey, and he's got his other hand on the sword. He's probably thinking, if one of these guys make a move, I'm going to cut his ear off. Yeah, he didn't even know he was going to cut a man's ear off at that point. But Peter was quick to react. And Peter, walking along with his chest stuck out, walking along, probably thinking to himself, we've been following this Jesus for the last 3.5 years. But now he's finally getting the recognition that's due to him because of what he's done. These people are finally getting it. They're finally seeing that Jesus is Jesus and that he's walking along proudly thinking, man, I'm so glad to be a part of this. I'm so glad that Jesus chose me. And I got to believe that John was walking along beside them. And John, walking along and thinking, man, I have loved this man. And now I see for the first time, I've been everywhere he's gone. And he's been thrown out everywhere he's gone. But now these people seem to love him here in this crowd. Little did either one of them know. 5 days later, those same people were going to scream and holler, crucify. That's almost unbelievable, folks. How could somebody turn that quickly against God? Okay, it happens every day. It does. But as Jesus is walking along, he looks at Andrew is probably there. One of the first disciples that he called, Simon Peter and Andrew. And Andrew was Peter's brother. And he's walking along too. And walking along and seeing the crowd and admiring the people. And no doubt, on the journey that he's been for the last 3 years, he's recognizing some of these people in the crowd as they walk along beside Jesus. They're standing on the side of the road, waving and cheering and throwing their clothes down and throwing palm branches down and cheering on the king as he comes. But they're being recognized, and they see who they are. Now, are y'all with me? We're on the road going into Jerusalem. Jesus looks up and he sees, I wrote some of these down, he sees a man standing there that never before was he able to stand in a crowd of people. He wasn't allowed to go near people. He never was able to go to church. He was separated from his family. He couldn't even commune with his family. They couldn't see him. He couldn't see them. He was in exile because he had been a leper all his life. But when Jesus came along and healed him, but now he's standing in the crowd and cheering and said, I know him. He's the one. The reason I'm here is because he made me clean. He's the one that changed me and told me that he could make me whole. Don't you know that leper was one of the ones that was praising God that day because he had everything in his life to thank Jesus for? Oh, I can imagine that leper as he stood there that day watching Jesus come down that little road on that donkey, thinking, that's my king. That's my Lord. There's nobody that could have done me like he did me. I'm telling you, at that crowd, if you look further in the crowd, you'll even see the man that they buried. I believe he's standing there. He might have been walking with him. I don't know. The man that they took and buried in the tomb. And he was wrapped up in his grave clothes. And he was there for 4 days in the tomb. But Jesus came where he was. He was 4 days late. They said, Mary and Martha, his sisters, said, why were you so late? He said, it's for the glory of God.
Yep.
And Lazarus is standing in that crowd. And he's probably telling somebody, y'all may not know who I am, but I was once dead, but now I'm alive. I was ready. He called me out of the grave and brought me back to life. Folks, I'm telling you, that had to have been a day where there was people murmuring all up and down the road. Hey, that's Lazarus. That's the one he rose from the dead. That's the one he brought back to life. They saw who he was. Folks, when you see people that Jesus has touched their life and brought them back to life, you shout too.
Yeah.
And so he's looking through the crowd. I got to believe that Mary and Martha are in that crowd. Mary and Martha, Mary sat at Jesus' feet many times, worshiping him. Martha served in the house everywhere Jesus went. At their house in Bethany, no doubt they had dined with Jesus. They had made meals together. Jesus would stop by. And they would worship the Lord right there in their living room. Can I tell you tonight, you can do the same thing in your living room. You can worship the true and living God no matter where you are. He's there. He lives inside of you. All you've got to do is acknowledge his presence. And listen, when you really get real with God, and I'm not talking about this fake stuff. Well, Lord, I know you're here. God bless you, Lord. Thank you for showing up. No, when you get really real and you get on your knees somewhere and you begin to cry out to the holy God, the one that saved you, the same one that brought Lazarus from death to life, the same one that healed the leper, then you begin to realize and God begins to work inside of you and something happens in that room where you're at. You try it sometimes, Stephen,
yeah.
Don't.
Yeah.
Lazarus was there. I got to believe there was a man in that crowd. And for the first time, he's really getting a good look at Jesus. Because you see, Jesus found him on the side of the road begging because he was blind. His name was Bartimaeus. He sat on the roadside, it says, on the way, and Jesus came by, and he called out, Son of David, have mercy on me. And when he called out, he came to where Bartimaeus was, and he said, what would you have me to do? He said, get up and see. And he gave him his sight back that day. He's standing in the crowd. He didn't see him much that day because Jesus moved on. But now he's watching the one that gave him sight for the first time in his life. He's seeing him face to face. Can I tell you tonight, he's got a better view today than he ever had, even in that crowd. He's walking the streets of gold with Jesus today. That's where you and me are headed today. But listen, there's something better ahead of us. And we were once blind, but now we see. Praise God. Lazarus was there. Bartimaeus was there. Don't you know? That there was a young man on the side of the road that day. And somebody asked him, said, what are you doing here? He said, oh, listen, let me tell you what happened to me. He said, they was carrying me out of the gate. My mom was the widow of Nain. And I was already in the casket. I was headed to the grave. But this Jesus met us on the way out of the city. We was coming out and he was coming in. And when he came up to the casket that I was laying in, he touched the casket. And I sat up and began to talk. He brought me from death to life. That's why I'm here. That's why I'm saying praise God. Because I know who he is.
Yeah.
Oh, listen. That crowd was shouting and waving, throwing palm branches down. But there were so many in that crowd. The widow's son was there. Don't you know that there was a lady there with long hair? She was standing by the wayside. And somebody asked her, said, how do you know this man? How do you know this Jesus? And all is, he cast 7 demons out of me. I was as wretched and vile as a woman could ever be. But he sought me and he bought me and he cast those 7 demons out of me. And I slipped up behind him one night at supper and I took my hair and I took that ointment and I washed his feet and with my tears and my hair. Listen, that lady name was Mary Magdalene, and God knows she was standing in that crowd today, and somebody asked her, said, why are you here? Why are you doing here? What are you doing here? Do you know this man? And, yes, I know him. Yes. Without him, I wouldn't even be alive today. Mary Magdalene was worshiping God. Listen, I got to believe that this woman, she was probably there. The Bible never named her. But don't you know she was standing on the side of that road that day, looking for Jesus. She only got a glimpse of him that day she met him. Because she had to crawl to Jesus. She had the issue of blood for 12 years. And when she crawled up, she couldn't even get close enough to get his hand. But she crawled up behind him and touched the hem of his garment. And he turned around and he said, who touched me? And she stood up and she fell to her knees in front of him. And she began to confess her sin and said, it's me, Lord. And he said, your issue is made whole. And her bleeding stopped after 12. Nobody could help her. But now here she is on Palm Sunday praising God and saying, thank you, Lord, for what you did. You cured me. You healed me. And now I love you with all that I am. Yeah. Oh, that woman, as she stood there that day looking at Jesus. What a day that had to be for these people, folks. As they saw Jesus coming in. Don't you know? Folks, we've got sin in our life. We've done stuff that we shouldn't have done. Every one of us sitting here. Yeah. Listen. If I were to give you my whole testimony, probably run me out the door. I'm serious. This woman was in that crowd that day, I believe. And she was ashamed at one time to even be seen among other people. But one day, she walked out in the heat of the day to draw some water at Jacob's well. And there sat this same man that was on the donkey this day. It's the same one that sat on the well when she got there at noon that day. And he asked her for a drink of water. And she said, I ain't got nothing to do. You're a Jew. I'm a Samaritan. What have I got to do with you? And Jesus said, you only need the water that I offer you. You would never thirst again.
Yeah.
Don't you know those words were ringing in her ears as she stood there watching Jesus ride by on that donkey? And somebody said, lady, why are you crying? Why are you so excited? What's your problem? And she said, oh, you should have been there. You should have been there the day that he found me at the well. Yeah. He told me all about my life, about my 5 husbands and the one I didn't have. And he changed my life. And not only me, but the whole city went out to meet him, and everybody that met him got saved that day. Oh, listen. Could you imagine being in that crowd, seeing Jesus walk by? Folks, you're going to get a glimpse of him. You're going to see him face to face. He's not going to be riding a donkey when you see him. He's going to be sitting on the throne in that place called heaven. If he doesn't come back and sit on the cloud, he's going to come back and stand on that cloud and get us. The woman at the well was there. I got to believe there was a man there. He was never mentioned by name. But when Jesus came into the sheep gate, the sacrificial gate, there was a place there called Solomon's Porch. It had 5 porches.
Yep.
And this man had been there for 38 years, suffering. But when Jesus saw him, he looked down upon him. He said, "What can I do for you?" And the man said, "I don't have no man to help me. I don't have any way of being healed." And Jesus just looked at him and said, "You don't need that water. You need me." He said, "Rise up and take your bed and walk." Don't you know that that man at the pool of Bethesda was there on the side of that road that day cheering on Jesus and saying, "I know him. I know who he is. I met him one day when I couldn't walk. I couldn't walk. I couldn't do anything on my own. I had to have somebody carry me every day to labor that crazy pool hoping I'd get healed. And when I could have been healed a long time ago had I met Jesus before that."
Yeah.
He's probably crying out and saying, "Thank God. Thank you, Jesus, for what you did in my life." Oh, the man was there. How about the little boy that took the lunch that his mama packed that day? I wonder if he was in that crowd that day. And somebody said, "Little boy, what are you doing here? You ain't even old enough to go to church. What do you know about God?" Oh, he said, Let me tell you what happened one day. We were out in a big grassy field. And said, Jesus came. He sent one of his disciples. And they asked for my lunch. And I gave my lunch to him. And you should have seen what happened after that. Jesus took that lunch and he held it up and he prayed to his Father. And all of a sudden, my little fish and my little loaves of bread begin to come out of that basket. And he fed 5,000 people, more than that, with my two little fish and five loaves. I couldn't believe it, but now I believe it because I was there. I saw it. It was my lunch. And I'm here to tell you, he is the Savior of the world. He is the Son of God. I saw what he could do. All these people, the faces in the crowd. There was a little girl. I got to believe she was there. She was the daughter of a man named Jairus.
Yeah.
Sent his servant to fetch Jesus. "My daughter is dying. Would you come and heal her?" Jesus found out who he was. And then he sent word again. He said, "Tell Jesus he don't have to come. If he will just speak the word where he's at, my daughter will be healed." He spoke the word, and his daughter was healed that same hour.
Yeah.
Don't you know that little girl was in that crowd seeing Jesus for the first time? Because see, Jesus never went to her house. But now she's seeing the one that gave her life back. She was dead, but now she's alive. Oh, listen, I got to believe in that crowd. All these people that we're seeing tonight, there's so many. And you know, we're guilty. The woman at the well was so guilty and so ashamed of the things that she had done, but yet now she's standing free and set free from her sin. She's standing and praising God with all that she is. The woman with the issue of blood is praising God because she's no longer suffering. The blind Bartimaeus is now praising God because now he can see. But what about this last woman? What about this woman that they brought to Jesus in the very act of adultery? Oh, she's in that crowd.
Yeah.
And she looked around at everybody around. And she probably, listen to me, she's probably recognizing some of the people that she dealt with in the past.
Yeah.
They're probably in that crowd. And that was some of the same people that 5 days later said crucify.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because they were the ones standing there when he rolled in the sand. And when he rode in that sand, he looked up and they began to drift away. He said, "The first one that has no sin, go ahead and cast your stone." And they began to leave, starting with the eldest. I don't know what he wrote in that sand, but don't you know that woman that was caught in the very act of adultery, if she was standing on the side of that road that day, she looked at Jesus and she began to weep and said, that's the man that forgave my sins. And I have not sinned again. I've never gone back to that lifestyle. I've been changed forever. And folks, listen to me tonight. I believe Jesus saw some of you in that crowd. You say, how did he see me? I wasn't there. I know, but your sins were. He saw everything about the future going down that road to Jerusalem. Why do you think he began to weep? They rejected you, and we rejected him. Some of us have waited too long. Some of us have put Jesus off far too long.
Yeah, come on.
It's time to get right with God.
Yeah.
Yes.
He said, if you don't cry out my name, I'll have the rocks worship me.
Yeah.
Folks, listen to me tonight. As I picture this in my mind, as Jesus is going down that little road in Jerusalem, all these people that he either healed or brought back to life or changed the leper, all these miracles that he did, they had to be standing in that crowd somewhere. But isn't it funny? Isn't it odd that some of those same people, and I don't think these people did. I don't think these people that he saved did. But a lot of those people that was in that crowd, just 5 days later, turned their backs completely on the Son of God,
yep,
and said, take him. They were offered a way out.
Yep.
They said, we'll give you Barabbas. Let Jesus go free. No.
Yeah.
No, let Barabbas go free.
Yeah.
And take Jesus and crucify him. Folks, I don't understand that. I don't understand how much hate could be developed in a person to say that and do that. But folks, it happens every day.
Mm-hmm.
We see people today on the streets of our city that have no regard for human life whatsoever. They had just as soon shoot you and leave you alive.
Yeah.
It's true, folks, but it's sad. Because one day, they're going to see the same Jesus that me and you see. They're going to meet him face to face. And they're going to kneel. And they're going to confess that he is the Lord of all. So I don't know if you try to, what I'm really trying to do is get you to see if you were in that crowd, if you would have been shouting, Hosanna to the highest, what has he done in your life? What has he done for you and me? Would we worship like they did? Would we cry out that he is the Lord of lords and King of kings? Would we address him as our Lord and Savior? Would we be shouting to the world, even though they were trying to shout him down? The Pharisees and Sadducees said, well, be quiet, be quiet. They got louder, and they said, no, we'll never be quiet because we know what he's done for us. And folks, the church of the living God should be the same way. We should never get silent about our God because we know what God has done for us. But as I look and I survey that road that day, looking at all these people and where they came from and what Jesus did in their life, I see that road. But then I look over here and I look over there and I see the same kind of people. Oh, maybe he didn't cure you of leprosy. Maybe he didn't heal your sight. Maybe he didn't give you your life, your walk back. Maybe he didn't do a lot of the miracles you hear. But let me tell you what he did do. He reached down with his grace.
Yeah.
And he saved you by his marvelous grace. Yeah. That's what he did. And so tonight, give God the glory. Don't stop worshiping him. Don't listen to the world. The world tells you to shut up. And they don't want to hear about Jesus. You ought to praise him all the more for who he is. Would you stand with me? As we say. Come to Jesus. Were you in that crowd that day? Can you see yourself in that crowd telling somebody what Jesus did for you? Oh, I can just imagine. I can imagine talking to that woman at the well. What did it feel like when Jesus saved you? Or I can imagine talking to Bartimaeus. What did it feel like when you received that sign? I wonder if Saul was in that crowd that day. The Apostle Paul. Oh, I wonder if there was a lot of people there. All I know is that if I could have been, I would have been in that crowd that day. I would have been praising God for what He did in my life. And so would you. Only God could have done what He's done in your life. Nobody else could have done that. He's worthy of our praise tonight, folks. He's a great God. Listen to the word.
Come today, there's no reason to wait. Jesus is calling.
Oh, do you hear it?
Bring your sorrows and trade them for joy.
Is He speaking to you?
From the ashes a new life is born. Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide.
He's right here.
Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide.
He's here waiting on you right now. Aren't you tired of living that old way? Don't you want Jesus to change your life? You come tonight. Oh, what a Savior
He is. What a Savior. Isn't He wonderful?
Just worship Him. Let's pray. Father, as well, I look at your word tonight and how you orchestrated that trip into Jerusalem that day. And many, many were in that crowd waving and cheering, God.
Yes.
The very folks that you saved and gave them life. Oh, God, we thank you tonight. Mm-hmm. And I hope that one day, we too will stand in a great crowd around the throne room of God together. So many from our church are already there singing and praising. worshiping you, God. Oh, how my heart longs to see them again. Thank you, Jesus, for the assurance that we have that one day we'll walk those streets with you. We'll see you face to face, and we'll meet all these people that we've been talking about tonight. What a joy that'll be. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Y'all have a good week. This is Holy Week.